couldn't make it to 30 Christmas party fundraiser spectacular. We are going to have everyone in the cast and perform a little something for you tonight. It's going to be a fun night of music and comedy and all sorts of Christmassy things. I'm going to start by introducing Paul and Aaron, who are going to be singing Baby It's Cold Outside. And Billy's going to come and host properly.
His birthday's coming up. His name is Jesus Christ. Take a drink, please. Thank you. I play the token gay, snarky gay, which is a stretch for me. I try really hard to be nice, and I'm going to try really hard to be nice tonight, and I want it to be very politically correct, and it's all for the children, so we will not be talking about Trick Palin. It was Sarah Palin's retarded baby. We will not talk, shut up, all right? We're not gonna talk about it. We're not gonna talk about JonBenet Ramsey. We're not gonna talk about Blanket. We're not gonna talk about that. We're gonna be very politically incorrect, which will be wonderful. And I want us to shout out, as the token gay, to the gays in Washington who can now get married or do not. That'd be great if they just let them get married, because we'd have no recession, no deficit, and every wedding would be under a mill. So we'd have a really good life ahead of us. And by the way, Jesus had two dads. Yeah, so I love Christmas trees. I went and got a tree. I bought it all under $100, which I think is great. I can't afford to eat this week, but I will have a fucking Christmas tree if that's how it is. Because I think Christmas trees are the best relationships you can have in the holidays. They are easy. A Christmas tree is always erect. They look good with the lights on. They smell nice. That didn't really make a joke, but you know, it's just, you can always break their balls. It's a great thing. You don't have to put up with it all year. You have it up for two fucking weeks and you call it a day. So anyone gets it's really upsetting to me that Michael Jackson and Farrah Fawcett got Patrick Swayze and Brittany fucking Murphy for Christmas.
Brittany Murphy!
Right? Can you believe it? I'm not even talking about this right now. I can't stand that. But, and then for Christmas, we got Tiger Woods. Does anyone care about Tiger Woods?
No!
Thank you. Who cares? Thank you.
You've heard this all before. Get out.
Tiger Woods! I'm being supportive! Tiger Woods!
I love it. We got Tiger Woods for Christmas. We got the Goslins. And they're not going away because those kids are young. They're not dying as quick as Brittany Murphy. Too soon, I know. This year. It came out in November, and it's been probably my favorite Christmas album of all time, and it's only been out for a month. And I'm gonna sing a little bit for you right now.
Oh my goodness, take a moment.
I want your love and I want your revenge. Major, you and me could write a better romance. Gift wrapping. Revenge, you and me could write a bad romance.
Yes.
Ho 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 ho, yes. Ho 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 ho. Sing with me, caught in a bad romance. La 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 la. It was my favorite album of the year, The Fame Monster. Thank you, Gaga.
Woo!
Thank you.
That was my Christmas joke today. That's one of my bar guests told me at work today at Chili's in Queens. And he was Spanish, so it was even funnier. But I won't say the accent because I don't want to offend any real Spanish people. But the joke is, why doesn't Santa have any children?
Why?
Why? Is he gay?
Because he only comes once a year and it's down a chimney. Please welcome Kristen Farrell. Christmas, and I don't know what I did with my paper, but I actually wrote down Linus's whole speech about what the meaning of Christmas was. Mainly because I don't understand it. What I love about it is that, well, it starts with lights, please, so it's such a production number, excuse me. And it starts with kind of a prepositional phrase, not really, but sorta, and he says, this is the meaning of Christmas. This is it. This is his response. Alright, so act like you just asked me what the meaning of Christmas was, and I'm gonna answer you.
What's the meaning of Christmas?
Lights, please. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. That was what he said. That's what he said. What the fuck does that mean? And I'm sorry. No. And this is probably not funny to people, but I was talking to these people last night. No, I really don't understand what it means. Like, his whole fucking speech. I could read it. It's boring. It's about the Lord and all that stuff. But I don't really get it because, first of all, what grade were those kids in? Anyone?
Kindergarten.
No, they were not in kindergarten. They were not.
Fifth grade.
Fifth, really? Charlie Brown was bald. What grade were they in? How did they understand that? And tell me how after they heard that speech, what they did was this. And then all of a sudden there was a Christmas tree. No, it's not that funny, but it's a really serious question.
Jack Frost nipping at your nose. Yuletide carols being sung by a choir. And folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe. to make a season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loading lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mother's child is gonna spy. They wanna know if reindeer know how to fly. Phrase. Take kids from 1 to 9 to 2. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you. Simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas.
Mazel tov.
Merry Christmas to you.
Feliz Navidad.
Next up is Carolyn Kimmel. And she is singing Santa Baby, which is appropriate because every man in her life is bald, fat, old, imaginary, and that was it. Come up here.
Santa Baby, slip a sable under the tree for me. I've been an awful good girl, Santa Baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight. My Christmas list, butter be new. Santa honey, I want a yacht, and really that's not a lot. I've been an angel all year, Santa baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight. Trim my Christmas tree with some decorations bought at Tiffany. I really do believe in you.
Play Matt in the show.
She's my BFF in the show.
This is my first acting project, so I'm very excited to be a part of it. I thank Brayden for that, by the way. With the project, I've been doing lots of training, lots of acting exercises every day, and some voice exercises too. But after a meeting at rehearsal, it was decided that I too shall not be one who sings. It was actually unanimous. So, now I feel awkward. I mean, it kind of prepares something if you want to hear a few bars.
Yeah.
Do it.
All right, well, I don't, wait, you know what, it's track four, actually, if you could just cue it up. So listen, I'm not ready yet. I didn't do my warm-ups like everybody else did, because I'm new. So just give me a second, just. Do re mi fa so fa. Kelly Clarkson, Kelly Clarkson, Kelly Clarkson. Do it for Kelly Clarkson. All right, let's do it. Yes. Is this where it starts?
Karaoke.
Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Should I say, I shall be doing more voice lessons, so please, you know, if you liked what you heard, tune back in. I'm sure I'll have a YouTube channel up soon, and I'll post a video. It'd be great, I promise.
Donate.
If you don't want to ever hear me sing again, put some money in the bin. There we go. There's an incentive. So next up is Jedenaya. She plays Sexy Naomi. And she'll be singing something by the Carpenters. Merry Christmas, darling.
Anthony back up to the stage, and he's going to resume hosting for the evening. Anthony!
Yay, everybody get
warm.
Oh, by the way, I'm not going to be singing right now. I was just told that A, I should not sing again, and B, that my Spanish is somewhat offensive. So I shall be not doing that again for a long time. Up next, we have Jenny the Office Slut from How to Make It 30. She has a theme song. It goes, Jenny the Office Slut. So, she's fantastic. She's played by Chrissy. And she will be singing Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas. So, without further ado, everybody, Chrissy Sheehan.
Thank you.
Tim Walter, I have the privilege of playing Simon Chase on How to Make It to 30. If you haven't seen How to Make It to 30, please go to howtomakeitto30.blip.tv. And use the number 30, all spelled out. We keep it simple. Please make a donation if you haven't made a donation already. So basically, we had some material written for us, and the only joke that I really, really loved was how I'm Jim Walter and I play Simon Chase. My character on the show is not gay, but I am gay for Christmas. I wanted to keep that. I'm going to keep my speech real short because I have a feeling the DJ is going to play some solid fist-pumping music that I can't wait to get into. Again, if you watch the show, you'll understand that. I had the privilege, fisting is gay and should be taken into consideration. Please protect your partner. And that's a scenario. I'm gay for good. I have the privilege of introducing the first performer to come up here, or probably second performer of the second act. Paul, coming to the stage. We were going to keep it PC, Merry Effin' Christmas. Fuck that. He's singing Merry Fucking Christmas. Paul's music is actually featured in the show, so thank you to him for that. Again, How to Make It to 30.blip.tv.
Merry fucking Christmas, that's what my family used to say. Open up the fucking presents, that's how we start the holiday. I won't be getting shit for Christmas. Santa's being a dick about this time. I spend the bills with money, why should wine? Let's watch the fucking gold log burn. Open up your fucking presents. Sit down and wait your fucking turn. I won't be getting shit for Christmas. Santa's such a dick about this thing.
Hit new series, How to Make It to 30. When I say critically acclaimed, it's like one or two comments that I read on the website. That you know, I'm pretty sure they were written by cast members, but that's cool. So, I really wanted to sing tonight, actually. I was going to sing, but I went to the audition and they told me, you know what, you acted the shit out of that, so if we do a straight play, we'll give you a call. For now, we're good. But I'm kind of upset because honestly, some of my favorite hits aren't featured tonight. You might be familiar with a little ditty called Dominic the Donkey.
Yeah!
Amazing. Thank you so much for the enthusiasm. All the Italians in the room. Awesome. You guys get like the sweetest songs for like different occasions. You never understand what they're saying, but you use funny animals that I'm pretty sure are drunk. Dominic the Donkey was definitely wasted in that song. He's just like walking around. He's like, sweet. The other one I like was The Chipmunks, All I Want for Christmas. Another one. I'm not going to do the impression.
Sweet. Don't do it!
Fine, I'll do it. Thank God for Megan's Mark. I just like the part where Alvin comes in and he's like, I just wrote the Karuma. for the kids. It's for the kids. But more importantly, singing one of my personal favorite Christmas songs tonight. In all seriousness, I'll Be Home for Christmas. Please welcome to the stage Miss Sydney McQuillan. To thank for all of this. Brayden Hay came up with the show and was like, you know what, I'm gonna go ahead and get in contact with a bunch of people that I've known through life who have been wanting to do this, willing to do this. We have him to thank for the show. He's gonna come up and sing Believe with Kristen Farrell, who you've already seen last night. Ladies and gentlemen, Brayden Hay, the creator of How to Make It to 30, writer, producer, editor, sound engineer.
Kristen's two drinks in her hand probably speak well for her.
This is water.
Yeah, she didn't slow down in that sentence. Anyway, we're gonna sing this song and hopefully you will like it.
Thank you.
once again on Christmas Day. Believe in what you feel inside. When you're doing something, there's no time to waste.
There's so much to celebrate.
Believe in what your heart is saying.
Tonight, you guys like the song All I Want for Christmas, made famous by Mariah Carey? She's about to put Mariah Carey to shame. Please welcome to the stage Nicole Weiss. So much for supporting the show. Again, howtomakeitto30.org.tv. I can't say enough. Please check it out. We're going to have this airing next week, and then the following week, episode 3, and then we'll be shooting more after the new year. Woo! Merry Christmas to all, and to all, get fucking drunk.
Children. sing. Snow is softly falling. Dreams are calling like bells in the distance.
We were dreamers not so long ago, but one by one we all had to grow up.
When it seems the magic slipped away,
we find it all again on Christmas Day.
Believe in what your heart is saying. Hear the melody that's playing. There's no time to waste.
There's so much to celebrate.
Believe in what you feel inside. And give your dreams the wings to fly. You have everything you need if you just believe. Trains move quickly to their journey's end.
Destinations are begin again.
Ships go sailing far across the sea,
trusting starlight to get where they need to be.
When it seems that we have lost our way,
we find ourselves again on Christmas Day.
Believe in what your heart is singing. Hear the melody that's playing. There's no time to waste.
There's so much to celebrate.
Believe in what you feel inside. And give your dreams the wings to
thank you.
Thank you.